Hey. I was going to talk about inspiration today. But first I want to mention that I did use Premiere Pro to create this video. It was an interesting learn. I will meet you over in the studio, just right over here, in a minute. Okay, this is my studio area at home. Would like to talk about an artist, one particular artist that inspires me. I wanted to make one comparison before I went into his work. I want to use Andy Warhol because he's an artist that most people know what his work is like. You are probably familiar with it. I think because he was so clearly identified in his genre. You know, he had a very particular look. I'm not putting him down for that. I love his work. It's amazing. And I'll show you a little bit of it here. But he worked with silk screening and hand painting canvases and just prints on paper, etc. But all of his work looked very similar from one to another. He had a method, had a process that he used, and he even called that process the factory, which is kind of indicates what he thought of how this was being done. He was very good, and that doesn't take anything away. It was a new idea, it was a new direction. But what I do like about this artist that I'm going to talk about is that he is multidisciplinary. He also has just let himself be, he'll do whatever he wants to do, doesn't try to fit into a mold. I think that's more contemporary because now with the connectivity in the world, you don't have to be as iconic in what you do. So the artist that I like is, or right now is my favorite, is Sterling Ruby. He has a very wide range of disciplines that he uses in producing his art. He had, and he's very successful, which is also, it's nice that he's successful because of his, even though he is very broad in what he tries to do. He started out doing ceramics, and one of the things about ceramics is that they can blow up from time to time. If you leave a little bit of air in there and it blows up the whole piece that you're working on. Well, he was working in larger and larger pieces, 3 foot, 4 foot across. I think some got bigger than that. But that is a problem, especially in a larger scale ceramic piece. He kept all the pieces. He would throw them into bins and buckets and on tables, and he kept them for years, and was eventually just kind of like, I love these pieces, that's why I'm keeping them, I need to use them somehow. So he would create these basin-like structures, or he jokingly called them ashtrays, but also they look a little like ashtrays, some of them. But he took those broken pieces. Some had already been fired and blew up, so they had color and were, had textures and whatever on them already. But he would throw those into these and arrange them in these basins and refire. And he'd, if he liked it, he might keep it, but he might add more of these broken pieces and refire it. And he would do that over and over and over again and it didn't matter to him how many times he redid it. He just did it in order to get the look he wanted. So he did that. He also has done these word posters that they're just totally different. You look at the ceramics that he did, and then you look at these word posters, you wouldn't necessarily make a connection between those two as, oh, that must be that same artist, which is something I really like. I like the fact that he could just let himself do whatever he wanted, not be constrained by what someone thought he might need to do or whatever. He also did soft sculptures. In addition to the soft sculptures, does polyurethane pours. He mixes large quantities of polyurethane, colors it in different ways, and he has built structures that he will create his sculpture from by pouring polyurethane over it. He's got some that look like stalactites. You know, they're huge, they're like 20 feet tall. He's got others that are more figurative. He's got one called the cup that I'll show you here. But again, very different from what he's doing in soft sculpture. He also did spray painted canvases or wood panels that were beautiful. They're very soft, colorful, bright, and just have a great feel. They, again, you look at this and then you look at the soft sculptures, and in a way I can't put them together, as you know, it doesn't look like one artist did that. But I like that he just goes off and is a little bit schizophrenic about, you know, what he wants to do. He's just like, well, I'm just going to do this because this is what I want to do. He also does large pieces of, they look like heavy equipment, truck beds or some kind of heavy equipment parts. They're massive, and North Park Mall actually bought one and has it out, or was on display recently. So he's just done these incredibly wide-ranging palette of things. You know, you go from one type of work to another, and that's what inspires me, is just his willingness to try things even though someone might not think he should go in that direction. But that's what inspires me. That's it. I wasn't sure if this applied to corporate life at all.